We've been doing auto steam for 12 years. It's kind of changed a little bit over the years, changed names a couple times. We kind of converged onto what we have today. The origins go back to actually a focus on robotics, engineering, and technology. And then when we merged it with a car show that was previously done at one of the school districts, we came up with the auto steam name and really solidified that automotive focus. It's helped supported by a variety of sponsors, the industry sponsorships, and our Center for Advanced Automotive Technologies here at the college. That's a National Science Foundation-funded organization, which really has a focus on encouraging the next generation, raising awareness about auto careers in automotive technologies, particularly the new technologies that are autonomous vehicles, the lightweighting, the vehicle electrification, all of those things that are new to the automotive industry right now. We need that new breed of engineers and technicians and technologists that are interested in these type of technologies. The industry partnerships are very critical to the Auto Steam event. We used to have a couple college pods with different departments and organizations in the college. I'm pleased to say that we had so much support from industry that the college pods were no longer space available. So it's all industry pods with industry talking about things that they're working on within the area. We've got General Motors and Ford and FCA, Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, Magna, American Axle, Kamau, Siemens, KUKA, all doing different pods relevant to things within their industry. So we're talking about coding in the sense of how you code for today's automobile. They talk a little bit about the lines of code that are in today's automobile, much more than a fighter jet, and that surprises people. Wow, today's automobile is that complex. So we need those type of technologies. When you go through the General Motors and the Ford and the FCA modules, you learn all about concept creation of vehicles, from the original imagining and rendering and sketching, whether that sketching is actual freehand sketching, the kids get an actual notebook that they can sketch with, or then the digital sketching that's done on the computer. And then you move over to the GM module and you see how those sketches come to life with actual clay models and digital 3D models. And you move over to the Ford module and you learn how you take those concepts and those models and now start to do pre-production planning with virtual reality. So you see some of those inklings of what goes on in this highly exciting and complex automotive industry that calls home to Southeastern Michigan. It's all interactive, it's all hands-on, so it's easy to get excited about it. And that's part of the ground rules with our industry partners is you can't just lecture to the kids, you gotta engage them, you gotta have that hands-on. So just as those kids are learning about things with their hands-on, then the music goes off and time to rotate to the next one. So it kind of leaves them wanting more, which is what we want, and then they can get some more at the evening event that's a companion event to today. I love walking around and just talking to the kids and seeing, from their perspective, what have they learned today? And we know anecdotally that's working from the responses that those kids give back. And then also data that we get. We do a pre and a post survey with the students that come through. How did this event change your awareness for careers in automotive and manufacturing? And we do see that swing, that increase in awareness from before the event and after the event.